So what's up YouTubers, welcome to another video on the channel. Today we have like an Outrider video. This is going to be semi just information, semi gameplay. I'm thinking of doing a fourth character. I have like three right now, so I think I'm going to do the last one as well. Just to make a build for that one as also. Today is just a general video. It's going to be about 10 minutes long, maybe 11 minutes, about the best mods in the game for the guns. You can talk a lot about the mods on the actual gear and stuff, but those are specific to each class. You get different mods on each class. So that's a bunch of mods basically. On the guns, it's just a few less mods, I would say, that actually is really OP for your... let me see if I have a Stargate ready here. For your build, so to say. I don't have Stargate, kind of bad. That's the one that is fun to do solo, because on tier 14 it's pretty easy. Boomtown is a little bit ridiculous. The drought place is okay, 14. But Stargate is the best one to do solo, I think. And even on 15 or on 14, this has a little bit low health and little less damage to do a solo on 15. In a good time, I would say. You can do solo with the build like this for sure on tier 15, but it's gonna take you a while. It's gonna take you more than what you need for 4 golds, if you wanna put it that way. Still, it's a really dope build. I changed this build out quite a bit as well. I don't know if I switched it so it got less powerful or they like nerfed something, because when I was using this gun, I was doing a lot more damage when I used that than the other gun with the crit damage. Maybe this is best for this build, that's why I do more damage with this gun, basically, than with this gun, because this gun should do more damage based on the stats, the crits and everything, but I don't feel it's doing it. But with the perks on the guns, guys, this has really... I can show this one though with a little bit gameplay with this gun and what this actually means, having these two mods. I can also show maybe a little bit about the trickster, what's the perk with that. But the gun mods on this one, for example, that is really OP is Embellish, Rage and Brain Eater. The thing with that mods are that you can shoot for an eternity and you never run out of ammo, since every 5 seconds after a killing shot, all shots will be critical shots, and critical shots don't consume ammo. So basically, if you're hitting those crits, which you will do if you're using like your special with the blighted rounds. If you basically hit with the blighted rounds every time and get a killing, you get all the shots after is critical. So no matter where you hit, you're gonna get criticals. And you will kill that last enemy kind of fast. If you don't kill him, you can kill the small enemies and you will like recharge your weapon with ammo, so your ammo never goes out, and basically blighted rounds never goes out. So your ammo is full and your blighted rounds, basically the perk never goes out. It's gonna be a little bit more tricky on tier 15 though with this specific build. Probably you can get a build that is even more firepower, or put in another way that you will like sustain it even on 15 forever. Because on 15 it takes more damage, so to say, to get the really strong enemies. So the crits need to be a little bit more higher to withstand with these mods, so to say. But those mods are generally good for tier 14 soloing and tier 15 if you do it in group, so no worries there. On this gun I have Sandstorm and Fortress. Fortress is another mod that is almost a must in this game. That or Dark Sacrifice. I'm going to show a little bit of the trickster as well in this video. what kind of mods I'm using on that gun. But here I'm using Sandstorm and Fortress, and for some reason these two perks combine pretty great. I have some really good damage numbers with this build. Even though I can't withstand the blighted drones that much, I still have trick up the sleeve. And I also can put, before I had like an extra mag here, so to say, or where was it? Yeah, I had an extra mag somewhere as well, so you can get like an extra off before it goes cold, I would say. Yeah, so this you can also use toxic on this build as well. But yeah, that was the point. Those two works pretty good together. I'm gonna switch over to my Trickster and watch and show you the Trickster one, what kind of combo I have there. There is my Trickster. And I might show a little bit of my Pyro, and then I might show like some gameplay with, I don't know, should I show the Technomancer? Maybe a little bit with the Techno, maybe a little bit with the Trickster. On this one I'm running Fortress and Dark Sacrifice, and that is really OP. Although the builds in this game is so varied, I don't know if they change the stats from day to day or what it is, but sometimes you do a run and you do a lot of damage and still you won't reach the goal. But usually it depends on your teammates as well. If you're putting out enough, like 200 mil or something, 250 mil, if they even do like 100 mil, you're easily doing a tier 15 pretty fast. But sometimes you are the carrier, and it's kind of, and if you're low health as a carrier, that's the worst, because you do all this damage but they don't do damage, but they got a review to do damage, so yeah. But anyhow, the thing I'm running here is Fortress and Dark Sacrifice on this one. Those are a really nice combo as well. Since you get 43% damage bonus based on your armor and you're in combat, Dark Sacrifice is a really OP one. I'm going to try that on my Technomancer as well, on the better gun that I have. I actually have that on one of those guns, Dark Sacrifice. It drains up to 50% of your max health. It's in exchange for 75% weapon damage bonus, and that's insane. If you have 195k in weapon damage and you put the crits on that, for example, if you have one of those guns, you're talking in big numbers there. You're talking, yeah, above a million on the hits you do, basically. If you have this is a Trickster, so I'm just running shotgun on this one, but yeah, you see my point. You can see in my earlier builds as well a little bit how these mods work on different guns. I can show maybe one with the Technomancer a little bit short before I end the video. If we switch back to my Trickster here. No, Trickster. Then I have the Pyromancer as well. Haven't used that in a while. That's a very more a group build or a group character. I don't know. I'm thinking of doing something with it, or like playing it a little bit more with it. But I have everything on it, and I need to improve the build though. So, but we're gonna proceed to the lobby. I can show maybe just do it tier 14. Hopefully we have a Stargate. I can show a little bit of a beginning of some expedition and see if I don't die. Always when I record, guys, I usually die. That's why I usually do the gameplay separate. But I can show, for example, the one I was talking about, this one, when I'm running that one. And just to show the point with it. Frontline is kind of not good. Heart of the Wild is decent at least. You can do a 14 on Heart of the Wild, even though that's kind of That's kind of not the easiest expedition, but it's not the worst either. Since we reached like 10 minutes on the video, I'm gonna show a little bit of the fast one here. Just to show how you can withstand the actual damage. The thing is, all my builds is basically group build, so when you're running this solo, a reminder is that it's not really built to do solo. Since you do a little bit like that, it goes pretty fast on those. Also on those, but if you kill the small ones, you can actually, you get it back, your like super thing. I also have splash on this one, which means everything I splash is gonna, it's gonna go on everything else too. But you see, it's go pretty fast. If I kill this guy, I have it still, so that's the perk with running those two mods on the guns. You like basically never out of, the only trouble you're gonna be in is basically when that goes out and you haven't killed like a, but you see, I do the boss pretty fast there, hitting it for 400 300, and you see all these counts as crits. If I get the critical kill there, all these kills goes for the crits. So everything I'm doing from there is basically crits. So that's basically a little bit point with the mods I'm running on this gun. It doesn't really consume your ammo. So you will basically keep killing, keep getting crits. Everything like that. This is still a pretty solid solo build. It's not the best solo build though. I can't fail with it if I run out of bullets. This weapon in itself is not that good. So this build really depends on if you can maintain your blighted rounds at the end. Also, a trick to preserve your ability is to just basically put out the special, because if you put out a special, your ability won't go back in that sense. It will still be there. Also in this you can do freeze, because freeze in this build does a lot of damage. That guy, for example, now I see I'm not gonna kill that guy in two. So instead of just wasting, I'm gonna do like this. Because then I get back my things here. You see there, if I were to kill him from the start, I wouldn't have my special bullets left. Because all that damage that I did wouldn't be doing any damage if I were to if I wait straight for him, my ability would have basically gone out the window. I think I will post this video tomorrow normal time for you guys. But it seems like Outriders right now is the videos. If people are looking for builds and stuff or mods, it's usually like that seems to be the case now. Also, you can be pushed, and then it's the trouble, because this build is not meant for, you see here, now I need to basically kill a goon, because otherwise my ability will go out, which is kind of bad. And this guy, he usually pushes, so he's annoying as hell. I can freeze him though. As long as you play a little bit chill with this build, there is no trouble. There is trouble when those push though, quite much. That's basically the most problem with this. It's when those big ones push you, because you can easily be stranded. Still, I like this build, I don't know why, I think it's just fun to spawn these all the time. one more, like, one. Now we're in trouble, I can say, because when he does like that and you're like low health, as long as you get one of those down, it's fine. And you can also do like this, just run around. That guy will be frozen though. But now I want some goons, you know, because that guy is like... You can also do like this. It's pretty good though. But this is the last boss, so I might as well blow my... You see there? There we got to the point where my ability was basically lost. Because I didn't do enough damage or hit enough crits. So that's kind of the drawback with this build. I think if you build it out and you can get rid of that with it, then it will be a build that's the most optimal ever. The thing you could do if you get a better gear piece is to put an extra mag, for example, and that will help with that situation. Then you can just go on more and more and more. So that could be an idea. But I will leave you guys here, I think, because I showed what I needed to do. Do a sub and a like to the videos for more Outriders stuff. And I see you in the next video. It's summer as well, so post when I can. So peace out.